Hi, Nadia.
Hi.
I'm Heath. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So I saw that you wrote in about an EV charger. You want to tell me a little bit about what you have going on?
Sure. So I have a plug-in hybrid.
Okay.
And I have amazing charging capability when I get to work, but at home, not so much.
Happens a lot. So everyone can charge them easily at work, but at home it's a little more difficult. So I'm guessing at work you probably have a level 2, but at home maybe using that one that comes with it, the one that plugs into a regular receptacle?
Exactly.
Yeah, and you only get 2 or 3, maybe 5 miles to the hour of a charge on that?
Yes.
All right, so we probably want to put a level 2 in here and make that a little easier on you.
That'd be great.
All right, so let's take a look at the garage, see how you use it, and we'll see what we have for options.
Okay.
All right, Nadia. So this looks like the level 1 charger that came with the car that you use to charge now.
Exactly.
When you pull the car in and you go to charge, where do you have to pull that cord to? Is it that side or this side?
It's on that side.
It's on this side, okay. So we have to drag that cord around in the way of the stairs, plug on this side. The good news is a lot of chargers come with a 25-foot cord, so you have some flexibility, but that's a little inconvenient and a little in the way. I would tend to think maybe if we put the charger somewhere over here.
I think that's a good spot.
All right, let's go to the basement, take a look at the power, and see how we get over here.
Okay.
So how long have you lived here, Nadia?
I've lived here for 10 years.
And did you get it new? It looks like it's about that age.
Yep, it was built in 2013.
Perfect. That'll help us with a little bit of an idea of what's in the walls and how things go. So it looks like from the size of the cable, we probably have either 100 or 125 amp service coming in. And with no main breaker, our breaker's outside somewhere. And it looks like we're pretty full, but we see a tandem in here. And a lot of times with these panels, even though we have a certain number of spaces, it may take more circuits than it actually shows. So what I want to do is I want to go outside and turn the main breaker off, lock this out so I can take this cover off safely, and see if we can actually add more to this without having to add a sub panel in order to put this charger in for you, okay?
Okay, great.
All right, be right back. When I'm doing electrical work on a box where the shutoff is remotely mounted, I want to be sure that I am the only person that can turn this main breaker on and off. This device secures the breaker in the off position, and I can add a lock to further ensure against the device being turned back on. A safety tag will alert anyone that work is being done in the house and not to tamper with the main. All right, that breaker's off and it looks like everything's off in the house, but we just want to double check and make sure it really is.
What are we looking for?
So the first thing I'm going to check is I'm going to use a no contact tester just to check that feed and make sure that's off. I know we have a label outside on the breaker that says it is, but sometimes things are mislabeled. So that says it's off, so we're gonna go ahead and take this cover off.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you probably don't get to see the inside of that too often. So, while that non-contact tester is pretty good, they're not foolproof, so I just want to check it with a meter to verify that. Great, so it's labeled correctly and the power's really off. Let me just set that aside. So now I want to look for a manufacturer's tag that's hopefully in the panel since we didn't have something that's specific on the cover for what we could do. All right, and there's our manufacturer tag, and that's just what we want to see. 30-40, so it's telling us that there are 30 spaces available and 40 circuits. So that means it's acceptable to install a certain number of these tandems, which is great news. So we can move a few of these around, make room for that new breaker, and install the charger without having to install an additional sub-panel over there.
Great.
So before we do that, I'd just like to take you upstairs. We'll take a look at the stuff that's going in, and then we'll get to work.
All right.
All right, Nadia, so this might look a little familiar, maybe similar to the charger you have at work.
Yeah, it's similar.
So this is a level 2 charger, and the advantage is you can install a level 2 charger without having to upgrade the entire service just to accommodate it. And what it does is it takes this little module that goes into the electric panel, monitors how much power is actually being used by the house, and if it finds the level's too high, it'll turn this charger back off. When it sees the level go down, it'll turn the charger back on. That way you don't have to upgrade the entire service just to have the level 2.
Love that.
Then what we're going to do is install a receptacle. So to get the actual power, we're going to take that receptacle, install this box with the cable, put that in, and then we can plug this right in.
So in the future, if I want to get a different charger, mm-hmm. can I change it out myself?
Exactly. That's the advantage of having this receptacle. So you can simply unplug the charger, unmount it, mount the new one, plug the new one in, and you're good to go. I mean, you know technology changes all the time, so I'm sure we're going to have something new in a few years.
Yeah, I love that.
So I think we have all of our parts. We have some wire here. We've got everything ready to go. I think we should get started. You ready?
All right, let's do it.
All right, let's get to work. So I'm going to give you the tape measure, and I'm going to give you this. So what we want to try and do is find a stud in this wall now that we know this is where we want the charger. And I want the stub because it's going to be a much more rigid mount for holding this in place. I don't have to worry about it falling out with a wall anchor.
Okay.
So what you do is it's just a magnet. So we want to wave that around the wall and just kind of drag it until we find it stick. Then we'll know there's a screw that's holding the drywall on. Right there? Perfect. Actually, that's a pretty good spot. So I'm thinking we'll put the charger right on that, somewhere maybe around 4 feet. The cord's going to wrap around the hook down here. And that gives us a spot to put the receptacle right there to plug it in. What do you think?
Looks good to me.
I think it's out of the way of the door, pretty comfortable. All right, so what I want to do next is, now that you have the tape measure, I'm going to have you pass it to me. And I'm going to go to the wall in the corner. And we're going to take a measurement to the center of this. Then we'll go to the basement and find this location. I want to go down there and drill up to make sure we can get into this wall before we cut a hole in the garage and make a mess that we have to patch. So I'll take that. And let's see how far off that wall we are. What do you have to the middle?
108.
All right, let's head to the basement and we'll go find it. All right, now if you want to take that and just hook it on the edge of the concrete, I'm gonna come over here. So our original number was 108?
108.
108, okay, and I'm adding for the thickness of the wall. So that puts us somewhere right around here. Great, so it looks like it's unobstructed and we should be able to get up there. So what I'm gonna do next is go ahead and drill that hole, make sure we can do that, run the wire, and then I'll come and get you in a little bit when we're all set.
Okay, great.
Down. I chose to use MC cable on this project because I like the physical protection aspect of it. I feel much better with this being fished up a wall, especially attached to a garage. Finally, I'm going to install the main current transformers and connect them to the device that's going to measure the electrical usage while the charger is in use. Now, I can turn the power back on. Hey, Nadia, you're just in time. So the level 2 car charger is complete. We put the receptacle in, it's tied into the panel, it's ready to go and use as is. And we also installed the energy monitor that came with that kit as well.
Awesome. Anything else I need to do?
The only other thing you want to do is you want to download the app that goes with this system. That'll just give you a little more control and flexibility over everything that it can do. But other than that, you're good to go. You can charge at home. You don't have to wait at work anymore.
Awesome. Looks great. Thank you.
You're welcome. Enjoy.
Thanks for watching. This Old House has got a video for just about every home improvement project. So be sure to check out the others. And if you like what you see, click on the subscribe button. Make sure that you get our newest videos right in your feed.